Welcome to another Mindburner video. Today, I've just received a parcel in the post. Quite a long parcel, which means that it's a synthesizer. It's been at least 2 weeks since I bought a synthesizer, so I just had to buy one. You know, it's like a disease I think I have. So I purchased a little Alpha Juno 2, I believe, from eBay, from a guy in Germany. It looked in good condition, and the photography was really good in the image and everything, and the synth's supposed to be really, really working properly. So we'll see how it goes. So this is a sort of unboxing of an old box, you may say. Okay, so time to open the box. It's got the good old words on it, fragile, and I really like this one. I don't know if you can see it, but it says, if I can get it around here. Oops. Do not throw. So that's always a good sign. Do not throw. So, let's open it up. So, first of all, nice little Euro 2 UK adapter, so that's good. Lots of nice packaging. Little eBay invoice. Euro power plug. Just 2 pin to work. It's all the usual kind of good packaging that comes. Nice instruction manual there, in decent quality. Some more foamy bits. Lots and lots of newspaper. So here we go. Here's the synth itself. Looks like Christmas every day when you're like old synthesizers. So this is the Alpha Juno. Alpha Juno 2, which I believe is the longer of the two. The Alpha Juno 1 had a smaller keyboard and didn't have aftertouch. I think that's the two main differences. I think there's another difference, but I've forgotten about. But that's the two main ones. So yeah, it's really nice, really solid, it's metal. Feels really chunky. So yeah, this should be fun setting up and having a look at. Gets a lot of good feedback online, the Alpha range. Some people say it's not as good as the older synths, like the Juno 660, 106, not as fat. Main criticism being the filter's not as good, or certainly not as feisty. But they say it can do also a lot more, so it has more waveforms, this particular synth, and it can be more useful today. So I just thought I'd get one because I have the GX8P and I have GX3P, so I always fancied one of these and I came up at a good price, so I thought I'd take a punt at it. Here we have the keyboard set up, so I'm just going to turn it on. So great, we have Alpha Juno 2 on the display, so things seem to work, so let's give it a rattle. Yep, that works. Nice brass sound actually, although I'm not a fan of brass sounds, but... Yep, number 2, string, yeah, lovely. Sweet. Piano, yep. Organ, yeah, usual sort of. Alright, polysynth, oh yeah, I like a bit of that. Nice little bell sound. Omnius. Sounds good. Oh, that's a nice string sound. Yep, very good. So, yeah, it seems to work okay. So that's good. I've connected up the Juno 2 to an old iPad that I had, and I'm using a program called IPG 800, which allows me to tweak all the parameters in the synthesizer. It's connected via a little MIDI plus MIDI interface, and that's the older 3-gen iPad, so it's like the wider 30-pin connector. But it just goes in the MIDI. Obviously, you can get this for much later, more modern iPads. And it allows you to tweak all the parameters. So you have things like LFO range, DCO, pulse width modulation, and the usual stuff, filters and envelope controls. So it's really, really neat. You know, you can get sort of... You'd only be able to see that change. I said earlier the filter is okay. It's not a thing to write home about, I don't think, but it's certainly not bad. You know, it's certainly an okay filter. I think when you just hear something like the Juno 60, it really does rock. It has a bit more balls, I suppose. But I mean, this is a really, still a really nice synth, and it doesn't detract too much from it.